Hello, hello, this is Hobbi Crochet. Today I want to share this cardigan, fancy puff sleeves, few flowers. I've decided to make this pastel color, but unfortunately I didn't have the same chunky pink color, so I was using bonus decay extra value. It is 100 grams and 306 yards, 280 meters. I was using 2 strand of it just to make up for the same quality, the same thickness of this yarn. So this is wave 4 yarn, this is wave 3 yarn. And this is what I was using. This was my blue yarn. Unfortunately, I haven't got the full pack. That's why I show you just that this is Cygnet Chunky. It is 156 meters in 100 gram. And because I didn't have the same pink, I was using 2 strands of this ordinary decay. A written pattern will be available down the description below. I prefer chainless beginning of the project, but if you prefer to do it with chain, it will be chain 25. And I will make chainless foundation row of single crochet. For that, chain 2, insert your hook into the first chain, pick the yarn, yarn over, pull through 1, you are making chain, yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Finish single crochet. Insert your hook into 2 loops. Find this V stitch on the back of your work. Pull yarn through, yarn over, pull it through 1 loop, make a chain, yarn over and pull through 2 loops. You finished your single crochet. I will make 25 single crochets. For the first row of the pattern, it will be herringbone double crochet. So instead of going chain 3, this is what you can do to replace it. You make just slip stitch, chain 2. This will kind of imitate your herringbone double crochet. And this is your pattern. Yarn over, insert your hook, pick the yarn and pull this loop through the first loop, yarn over and once again. This is kind of adding one, you add one more step at the beginning of your double crochet. So basically it is kind of like double crochet on top of slip stitch. And this will create nice pattern. To make it easier, I'm helping myself just holding it with your thumb and pull it through like this. The pattern goes quite quickly because these herringbone double crochets, they are even higher than double crochet, so quite like how it goes, and the texture is very nice. To start row 2, you will make again slip stitch and chain 2. This will be your first herringbone double crochet, and then you keep going till the rest of the row. The last double crochet will be on top of this chain 2. And then you just repeat this row 2 all over again. So slip stitch into the first stitch, chain 2. And continue with the herringbone double crochet into each stitch. My first decrease for our V-neck opening will be at the end of row 14, so I will go around making 14 rows of herringbone double crochet. This is the part we are making now. Straight part till we start making V-neck opening and underarm portion. At the end of row 14, I skipped one stitch. So I decreased one stitch. This will be side for the neckline. Row 15, I will skip 5 stitches on the other side for the underarm. Start the row as usual, slip stitch, chain 2, and I will see you at the end of row 15. I have left 5 stitches at the end of the row, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but to make this corner a little bit smoother, I will make decrease. So I will make this stitch and the next one together. This is half a stitch, and then I'm making into the next stitch also half a stitch, and then finish them together. For row 16, I will skip one last stitch at the end to form V-neck, and I will do this for 7 times. So 7 times I will decrease one stitch at the end of the row. So this row 16, I'm leaving one stitch out and turn my work. Row 17, I will skip one last stitch for underarm portion, and I will need to decrease 3 more stitches for underarm portion, but I want to smooth this edge, so I will show you how to decrease it. We will do exactly like we did here, 2 double crochets made together. So when you have 2 stitches left, I'm making half of the first double crochet and half of the last stitch. And finish them together. So I've reduced 5 stitches, 1 more 6, and I will do it 2 more times. I need to reduce 2 more stitches on underarm portion. And for the neckline, I need to reduce 7 stitches, so I will just keep going. And after you make all your decreases, It will be 8 decreases on the neckline, and then you decrease 8 stitches on the underarm portion. I will have to make one more row without any decrease, so it will be row 27. This is second part with the last row. I want to measure this for you, how to give you little bit them. So from top to bottom it will be 40 centimeters, or in inches it will be 15.5 inches, but you remember that this will stretch a bit. And the width of it is, if you measure it, the widest part, it is 10 inches or 25.5 centimeters. You see those edges are a little bit wavy. This is the type of this herringbone double crochet makes. Now let's make the back part. For the back panel, I've made 50 single crochets, foundation row of single crochets, and it will be very similar to the front panel. To start herringbone double crochet, I'm making slip stitch, chain 2, and then one herringbone double crochet into each stitch. I'm making 14 rows, and then it will be decrease from both sides for underarm portion. After 14 rows, you will have around 8 inches till you make decrease for underarm portion. And we will make the same decrease. So first decrease will be, we will decrease 5 stitches. This is first stitch. I'm making slip stitch, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I've reduced 5 stitches, and then I will start making first herringbone double crochet into 6 stitch. So it's kind of confusing how to make here slip stitch, because you already made a slip stitch over here. So I will just make chain 3 instead. It will be just fine. And start my row with the next stitch. This will be your first herringbone double crochet, and this is your second. Continue your row till you have 5 stitches left. Then we will make a decrease. Maybe leave 6 stitches, and we will decrease, make a smooth decrease like we did on the front panel. Six stitches left. Let's make 2 double crochet together. Half double crochet and one more. Row 16, it will be no increase, no decrease. Just place one double crochet into each stitch. Row 17, you want to make decrease at the beginning of the row and at the end of the row. So to decrease 1 stitch, I will make slip stitch into the second stitch and chain 2. Continue with the row and skip 1 last stitch. And then you will repeat row 16, 17 for 2 more times. And now after you've made this decrease, 5, and so now I've got 34 stitches and I will keep going till I have 27 rows. And then I'm making 2 rows of single crochet. I will start working a pattern. This stitch, instead of first chain of 3, I'm making single crochet, chain 3 into the first stitch, double crochet into the same stitch, and this stitch is double crochet, chain 1, double crochet. And this will be the pattern for the whole sleeve. And with this V-stitch you will make as many rows as you want your sleeve to be, as long as you want your sleeve to be. I place single crochet, chain 3 instead of chain 3. This represents my first double crochet into the same stitch, and then next V-stitch goes into the chain 1 space, double crochet, chain 1 and double crochet, to start shaping the sleeve. I want to first close 5 stitches. I'm making slip stitch 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Chain 2 and continue the row with the same pattern. Leave 5 stitches at the end and place last double crochet into the 6th stitch. Next row, single crochet into this stitch. Chain 2 will work as first double crochet, chain 1, double crochet into the same space, double crochet into the next V stitch, chain 1, double crochet. I will continue making V stitch and gradually I will do decrease all over the sleeve to shape it.